Hi, Lawrence Lowe here, resident conductor of the Pittsburgh Symphony. We're here in Stuttgart, about to play our second concert of the tour. The first concert went really, really well, and we're looking forward to a second concert, again with Anna-Sophie Mutter on the Brahms Violin Concerto, but this time the second half of the concert. Instead of Dvorak 8, we have Mahler 1. So we have preparations happening with the offstage trumpets and the correct location, the correct dynamics. And one thing I'd like to do is find out what some of the musicians do before a concert, especially in a new hall.
Yeah. Okay, well, here we are outside the backstage, about to go in, talking to Zach Smith, who, did you just arrive to the hall just now?
I did, just a few minutes ago. I wanted to get here before the concert started to make sure my colleagues were healthy and had everybody on stage. I was early enough that if I needed to scramble, get dressed, get my horn, get out and play the Brahms, I was able to do it. But I would play till the second.
Well, it's good because Mahler 1, I mean, you have 8 horns on the stage. It's like the most triumphant thing. Is this a tradition for the horns to stand at the end?
Mahler actually wrote it in the score. And we don't stand in the spot where he has us marked, and it's marked in the score, because do stand. Blah, blah, we'd miss every note. So
right.
We wait until there's a transition. It's a few measures out, and we wait, and we know we're going to stand, but we wait. Bill goes, and we all go up. And I got to say, it's probably pure ego, but it's just an incredible feeling.
I mean, we in the audience have this overwhelming sense of triumph when that happens.
We do too.
And for you too, that's amazing.
Yeah, we really do. And you know, and it's not just an individual personal thing, but the music's really so incredible at that point, and you're standing up and you can kind of feel, it's almost a gasp.
Oh,
that comes,
it's incredible.
And I can't believe the horns are the ones who are so lucky to get to do it.
It is awesome.
It really is
a great
moment.
Hey, I was noticing over here in this truck, they cook here.
Oh.
They have a stove, it's like camping. This is like the ultimate camper. My in-laws would love this, they live in Colorado.
This is orchestral tailgating.
Now I know I'm not really supposed to videotape on the stage, but I just wanted to say, or show everyone where the trumpets are going to be, because they have to find a space off stage to play their part in the Mahler. I'm talking to the video camera here. Everyone's looking at me really funny. So I'm just gonna zoom right up to it. They're up there in the chorus loft. They're up here in the chorus loft, and they're going to be behind that camera, behind that door. And so they'll play, they're off stage there. We did a little test run, and it works really well. That video camera is hooked up to a monitor backstage so that they can all hear the, or see the conductor and play their offstage part. Lou, I found you here in the stairwell. Lou Lev. Do you always have to find some, I mean, when you go to a new location, you have to find a place to warm up?
Absolutely. I mean, people are working on stage, people need to get dressed. There's always a hunt for that special space.
And this is a good spot, huh?
Oh, look at it. It's picturesque.
Solitude.
Beautiful. And the sound. Something special.
Nicole, hi. Oh, I'm not supposed to blog you. But I'm excited here because my seat partner, you guys can go through, is Dr. Ted Osiel, who has showered, right? So it's okay. See, yesterday I had the very unfortunate, yesterday in our first concert in Basel, Switzerland, my seating partner was a random, extremely smelly guy, but it's okay. I survived. Today I get to sit with Dr. Ted, our tour, the Pittsburgh Symphony official doctor. So if anyone knows about hygiene, it's Dr. Ted.
Are you on?
Yep.
This is a brand new reed. I just pulled it out of the box. It has never played a note. And for some superstitious reason, the first note every reed plays is on a B. That note here.
How is it?
It's a typical new reed. It's very heavy. Needs to be thinned out.
So how do you do that?
I put a plaque between the blades. I get out a file. I run the block. Wait. There, that's good. I don't have my usual setup. It's a little awkward. Then we file away on it a little bit. Just a bit at the tip. And that might, that'll loosen it up. This one has been playing for a couple of years now, but I don't play it very often.
Uh-huh.
So if you played on it all the time, maybe a couple of weeks, I suppose, but you really, oops, there's a little split in that one. Here, you can have that.
Oh, excellent.
Wait, put it right here. See, that just came off of my reed.
Is that a good thing?
It's not a great thing, but it's not going to hurt it. Is that her?
Looks like it.
Yeah,
sounds like it. Sounds like our soloist on stage warming up, Anna Sophie Mutter, but I'm not sure if it would be appropriate for me to videotape her. So we can hear her.
The hardest point in the whole concert for me is when she's done with the cadenza.
Mm-hmm.
She's playing now. That's when I come in with the softest possible 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 notes I ever played.
Can I interview you for the blog?
For the blog?
Yeah. I mean...
Is Meister calling me?
Well, I mean, we're here 10 minutes before the concert. But how long has all of this been here before the concert?
We started at 3:30.
3:30 in the afternoon?
Yes, today.
But what about the whole process of getting everything here? When do you start doing that? Like, as soon as the concert's over?
Yes, as soon as the concert's over last night, the truck actually took off and they drove all night, and we met it here at 3:30.
So what do you do in your free time?
Drink beer and what else?
Well, tonight's concert went really, really well. The audience clapped so, so long, and I was in like the fourth row, and it was really amazing. So tomorrow we are off to France, so I decided to use this cheesy special effect. I mean, I'm really in France. anyway, so I'm sure I'll make another video at some point. So until then, thanks for watching this, and see you later.